Why Premier Mark McGowan has accused the state's police union of going rogue after it told officers to only respond to life-threatening and emergency call-outs. The Why Police Commissioner yesterday used special powers to force officers to abort the industrial action, hours after the union made the call to escalate to Phase 3. Mr. McGowan said the move had backfired and the union had lost public support. The police union's industrial action announced late yesterday was irresponsible, unnecessary, and reckless, Mr. McGowan said. While the police officers themselves behave responsibly and put community safety first, the police union's leadership went rogue. Police Minister Michelle Roberts said it was a deliberate attempt to catch the government unaware. The dispute will be heard by the Wire Industrial Relations Commission later today. The union issued a statement on Tuesday afternoon calling on all officers to only leave their station or section to attend emergencies or other urgent tasks. However, hours later, new Wire Police Commissioner Chris Dawson issued a message calling for all officers to respond and perform normal duties. In the statement, he said the action proposed by the union had the potential to impact community safety. As all officers can appreciate, any call for assistance by members of the public can escalate, the statement said. It is our duty to respond to all calls for police help. He said in accordance with Regulation 401 of the Police Force Regulations 1979, all officers are directed not to follow the statements in the union's newsletter and perform their duty. The regulation requires officers to carry out functions, duties and responsibilities as directed by the Commissioner of Police. The union immediately backed down, issuing an urgent broadcast telling officers to resume duties. However, police will still enact a work to rule policy where they will not perform unpaid overtime, complete all paperwork only at a station, and use discretion to issue cautions rather than fines for traffic and liquor offences. They will also conduct highly visible welfare checks on speed camera operators. Union President George Tilbury said in a statement that after 6 months of negotiating in good faith, and suspending their industrial campaign to allow for high-level talks, they had not received an adequate offer from the government. The Wire government has capped public service pay rises to no more than $1,000 in a bid to claw back $500 million over 4 years. It replaces an earlier policy capping pay rises at 1.5%.